What a view and what a day. Absolute beautiful day here in Cohuna. Give us a thumbs up if you can see us. It's Amy. Going live with our 51st episode of Lunchtimes with Locals. And I've got a pretty exciting episode for you today. We're going to try something a little bit different. I'm going to be using Telstra data, so hopefully the connection doesn't drop out. But yeah, we're in for a bit of fun. So give us a thumbs up if you think you know what's happening today and where I am. But yeah, it's going to be a little bit of fun for us all. Yeah, I'll go back. So basically, I'll turn the camera around and show you where I am. I'm in this part of the street here, and today I'm going to start by introducing you to the team at Colours, Cones and Coffee, which is a beautiful, relatively new little business in Cohuna. Obviously for sale there, so you know, ask your questions if you are interested in moving to Cohuna or taking over a profitable little business. And we'll come and we'll talk to the owners in here a little bit more about that. Maybe one of them, I reckon the other one's gonna run away. And then we're gonna go on a little bit of an adventure. So I'm not sure if anyone knew that Cohuna had an ice cream shop. It doesn't just sell ice cream, we've got coffees, we've got smoothies, toasted sangers. Yeah, they've got absolutely huge menu. And how they've decked it out, it's sort of in the rock and roll sort of era. A lot of posters and pictures and things like that. I'm going to come in here and do a bit of a close-up on my favourite ice cream. If you're watching, let me know which one your favourite is. Hang on, I've got to find it here. All right, let's go. Now, Stairway to Heaven. Stairway to Heaven. I'm going to turn my camera around here, but there's someone behind me. Stairway to Heaven is exactly as it sounds. That's all I'm going to say. Do yourself a favour and come and have some Stairway to Heaven. Very randomly, my next choice is licorice. I don't even like licorice, and someone recommended I try the licorice ice cream from Colours, Cones and Coffee, which I did. I wish I hadn't, because now I have to have it on a fairly regular basis when I have a bit of a licorice ice cream craving. What flavour are you going with today?
Rock salt caramel.
Rock salt caramel is coming as a recommendation from a customer, a regular customer here. Yes, he is. Give me the thumbs up. All right, now we're going to come across here and we're going to talk to Justin. So here's Justin. There he is.
Hi, Amy. Hi, everybody.
Meet Justin. I'm sure lots of people watching have met Justin on their rounds about. You're around town everywhere.
I get around.
I did a bit of an intro before and said that you're Cohuna's busiest entrepreneur.
don't know about that. We're just bringing things to the community.
Yeah, you are, certainly. Yeah, how long have you been here for?
Oh, we've been here 2 years now. I was originally born here.
That's right, yes.
Came back, and so we've done the ice cream shop, which is really good, and we've got some new ventures underway. So as you see, the ice cream shop is for sale.
Yes.
We have a great husband and wife, father-daughter team.
Yes.
Great shop, easy ran. Yeah, lots
Kirsty there over behind us, nodding her head? It's easy to run. yes, there yes, she is. Yes. Probably the only thing is getting the staff members, which a lot of businesses are kind of struggling with at the moment.
That's
so,
much
yeah, that's right. And because you've got you sort of need to be open on the weekends and stuff for the holiday makers and for the locals to come and enjoy
their
coffee.
Great support from the community. Locals, it's fantastic. The community that we've had.
Yeah.
The support that we've had from the community. And we had a lot of tourists that come to the caravan park now, and their first stop is the ice cream shop.
Yes.
So it's getting well known.
It's
so
becoming like a tradition for
it
their
is.
Families. The
it
parents
is.
Can get their coffees and it ice cream, is. And the kids can get their favourite ice cream flavours.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
That's fantastic. So you've been here 2 years, but we class that as your returners. So Shannon and myself are returners.
Correct.
As well.
Correct.
So someone that's known the joy of living here and how beautiful... Yeah. The environment is and how supportive the community is, and then has gone off to have a little bit of a different experiences in life and then come back.
Yeah, look, why wouldn't you come back?
Yeah.
I mean, have a look at the place. It's beautiful.
Yeah,
so,
that's right. So,
yeah.
So everyone, all of our viewers actually always agree with that. So we have a lot of people from that are ex-locals that like to watch and catch up with what everyone's doing. We've got a few people watching today, 23 actually. They must be pretty excited about the special treat that I'm about to endure, not endure, get to go in. All right, let's head out there because like Justin said, he has just started, well, We'll talk about the other business when we get there, but he's just started a brand new business. And he's going to surprise us. All right, I'll turn it around. We don't want to spoil the surprise. Yeah, he's just started another new business, and it's called It's Here, Limos, Sedans and Vans, Chauffeured Hire. I think I got that wrong, but I did already tag it in the description here. So he's bringing something to town that we don't necessarily have here, which is the chauffeured vehicles that you can hire for events and for, basically anything. Golf trips and hen's days and weddings and things like that. Christmas parties, they're available for hire now, and he said he has had a lot of, interest already. So make sure you get in touch very soon. If you've got any questions, let us know while we're on air and we will try and answer them. But he's just preparing one of the vehicles for me, so I'm a little bit scared about what's actually gonna happen in a second. Justin's a funny character and oh my gosh, okay. I'm not sure if you can hear that, but this is gonna be pretty fun. He's going to actually take me around to his other business. I'm going to get a special ride in...
let's go and have a look at Cohuna's newest craze.
Let's go and have a look at Cohuna's newest craze. Oh my goodness. I don't know if I'm the first one that gets to go in this, but what do we got here?
This is the limo van.
The limo van. How many people can go in here?
14 passengers in the rear.
Yes. So, and one in the front as well. And it's chauffeured, so you...
So it's not... It's not you hire, we drive you.
Yes.
Fully insured, of course.
Yes. Lovely.
So Christmas outings, wedding transfers, pub crawls, laundry days.
My God, I'm sold. I'm sold already. All right, looks pretty inconspicuous from the outside, but what are we going to see on the inside here? OMG. All right, come in here and let's see. What do you reckon, everyone? How cool is that? Probably blasted you with the music. Oh, now the light's gone a bit weird, but that's okay.
So this is our 14-seater party bus, limo bus, minivan, whatever you like to call it.
Party bus, all right. Oh my gosh.
The joy of this vehicle is it is a party bus, but we can turn all the lights off and air conditioning on it, and you can do a trip to bowls or whatever you want.
A bowls trip. They might want the music on, so, actually. Don't.
As I said, it is chauffeur driven, so yes. You don't have to worry about that. It, we book it on the hour or we do a day rate.
Fantastic.
We like to range from sort of 5 to 14 passengers.
Yeah, excellent. So, yeah. How amazing. All right, I think Justin's going to give me a little bit of a drive.
I am.
And I'm going to talk while we're going. So we can't have the music on, but I'll do a bit of a chat. But that was, I did actually request that song this morning. So
hold on.
I do feel like having a bit of a party now. Yeah, thank you. All right, I'm going to buckle up, guys. But if you've got any questions for Justin while we're driving. Oh, it has got seatbelts, I promise. I'm just trying to work out which seat I prefer to sit in. Actually, I'm right at the back here. So someone's commented, wow, that's so cool. Oh, Katrina, it is amazing. You should see it. And Justin's got a fairly good playlist, Spotify, all connected up. You could put your own playlist in, I'm sure. A party to bowls. That's exactly right. I'm sure the bowlers would like to have a bit of a party. Who else we got watching? Say hi, guys. Oh, Kirsten, hi. Thanks for watching. This bus might be good for the bridge to bridge. Imagine that. Get some pump up music for the marathon runners to head out to the start line of the bridge to bridge next year, which I see is going ahead, which is super exciting. We can't wait to get behind that great event. It's going to be so good to be able to start having events again. And I noticed that the Progress Association has just advertised that there's going to be a New Year's event. It's not going to be fireworks, but watch this space. We might have some announcements about that in the coming days. And they also have a Facebook page that they put updates on. So how's everyone going? A few more comments. Hi, Charlie. Oh, how good would this be? Getting the girlfriends together, have a few drinks, and get Justin to drive you over to Junction or over to OPT, I hope that's still in Echuca, the nightclub, or probably the Star Bar is probably more my age group. at the moment. So what's happened here is Justin has given me a lift to his other business. Oh my gosh, he's just, like I said, Kahuna's busiest entrepreneur. Oh, hang on, I'd better wait for my chauffeur to get me out. Here we go. And so here we are. We have just arrived at, oh, puppy's coming out to see us. We are at Cohuna Car Spa and Detailing. And looky here, this is my car.
No, it's not.
No, it's not? Oh, looks like it. My car must be inside. I dropped my car off here this morning. Dropped my car off here this morning and then walked to work, and I dropped my car off to have a little car spa. It's having the premium treatment of a hand wash on the exterior and then
full interior clean.
Full interior clean.
So steam clean
what
the seats.
Did I get? Steam clean.
Seats and carpets have been steam cleaned.
Fantastic.
All the plastics have been rejuvenated.
It's not going to know what's happened to it because I don't reckon it's been done for a while.
That's right.
I had a little mini clean when you first opened up. So
what I'll do is I'll wander in and get the boys to bring it out.
Yeah.
Wander in and have a chat about it.
Absolutely. Has anyone got any questions about the car spa? Sorry about the light here. Look how clean. Oh, I'll better turn the camera around. Look how beautiful and clean this is looking. Awesome. So, like we said, it is a hand washing car spa. So they haven't got one of the big automatic ones with all the lasers or the brushes or anything, so it's very good for your car, and you've got the personal touch of someone actually looking over your car and getting into all the nooks and crannies, and then they do the inside. Justin will probably tell us the rest about it, but I was looking on their Facebook page and they do treatments and polishing, and also I have seen that they pretty much wash and clean any sort of vehicle. It doesn't really matter. They've done motorhomes, they've done forklifts, they've done horse floats, they do boats, they do jet skis, motorbikes, anything at all. So I even see that people come over here from Echuca and lots of other places because there's not all that many car spas that you have. Oh my God, look at the Prado. Looking fantastic. Wow, she looks good. Let me have a look on the inside. I didn't tell you, but I took a before video
That's
this morning.
We've got nothing to hide.
No, and so I'll post that in the comments so that people can see. Oh, okay, that looks like brand new. Look at the windows, and the seats have been cleaned and everything. Oh, what a lovely treat this is. Because, tell you what, cleaning the car is one of my most hated jobs. Oh, it smells good. Fantastic. All around the trims, look, you've done the tires all black and nice. That is amazing. I am super happy with that. Thank you so much. I don't think Shan's going to know whose car it is when I turn up at home tonight. So, yeah. So this business is going all right then? Here
we go. This business is going very well, actually. Once again, the support from the community has been absolutely brilliant. We have a pretty regular clientele base now.
Yeah.
Always busy, as you can see. I've got two people employed now here.
Wow, fantastic.
Full time.
Wow.
So yeah, we're getting along. Summertime, we're closing a little bit early, around the 3:30 mark.
Yeah.
It's getting a bit warm.
But
between that and the oil, we also do all the Penrite oil products, which is a lot of people in the area are starting to come and buy them. So
yes, that's right.
That's good.
And I did a bit of a pre-stalk, as I normally do, on your Facebook page and your website. And I said, you know, you do all sorts of vehicles. What's the strangest vehicle you've ever, or strangest thing you've ever been asked to clean?
Well, a bit strange. The one that I've cleaned I didn't like was a hearse. I'm not keen on doing hearses.
Oh, okay. Yeah, but they do have to be nice and shiny.
We pretty much cleaned everything from as you said, the webpage, tractors, motorbikes, boats.
Yeah, tractor would be a big job.
Telehandlers, ambulances, the police cars.
Oh, I've seen them here before.
So we do pretty much everything. I'll clean anything.
Bring it in. A bit of a challenge.
Yeah, so I love a challenge.
Horse floats.
Yeah, we do horse floats.
Sort of
we
stuff.
Just got Sarah's
hey,
horse float the other day.
How are you? I haven't got you on video, don't worry. Oh, that's good. Employing the young locals before they go to uni. That probably works out really well for everyone, I suppose.
Yes, it does. It's good.
That's good. That's beautiful. I'm just having a look and seeing if we've got any comments here. I thought I saw someone. Oh, Charlie's got it booked for Saturday night. Because as we were driving, I said how good it would be to get the girls and have a few drinks and get it locked in over to Echuca.
It is going out, yes. It's giving back to the bus. It's taken about 20 bookings since I've launched it. So we need to sort of get onto that if you want to book a spot.
Absolutely. So it's going to be pretty flat out. And you've probably got some going into next year too.
When We also have a Chrysler sedan, which is near today. But for if you and your hubby or partner want to just chauffeur drive into to the club or in town or to a wedding or something, or pick up after a wedding, we also do personal chauffeur sedan service as well in our Chrysler.
You're the type of person I feel like you could just send you a message with, like, you know, with any of your businesses and say this is what we need, and you try and work something out.
We'll do our best to
endeavor
to have it done.
And that's
what it's all about.
This has been such a fun episode. I don't know if I told you, but it's my second last episode, and I wanted to have a little bit of fun with it. Next week, I'm going somewhere super special. I'm going to go over to the new Kundruk retreat with a tent. I'm going to go over and talk to Jenna over there. Yes. I started out the Lunchtimes with Locals at the Cohuna Caravan Park 12 months ago. So I'm going to finish with Jenna as well at the Kundruk retreat, and sort of a bit of a full circle. Good. But I've been wanting to come here, and I thought, how brilliant is it that I can show off three businesses at once?
And more to come.
You are an ideas man.
Well, we just like to see what the community needs, and we give it our best shot to supply that.
I know that when you first came to town, or in the early days, you did put a post on Facebook and said, what would everyone like to see in town? And it was amazing, the amount of different things that came. And even if someone suggested something, a lot of other people replied, we've already got that, it's in, you know, such and such. Correct. So it was a really good way of sort of connecting people with what we already do have here, and then trying to create, you know, businesses to cater for everything else. So
that's what it's all about, catering for the community.
That's right. So get in touch with Justin if you have any business ideas.
I'm always happy to have a chat about,
you know, how to start a business and things like that. So, thanks for...
But we do have a few more about ideas. Oh, I'm not going to say much yet.
Oh, come on, all
there
mysterious.
There is a couple of new ventures early next year.
Yeah.
So,
that quick.
Yeah, wow. In the pipeline. Yeah, so good job. Get them things out. And I'd just like to say thank you to you, Amy, for what you do for us and the community, and letting know that what's out there. And it's great for the small businesses too. It gives us that little bit of a buzz and a little bit of face time. And
exactly.
So what you do is absolutely, it's fantastic, and I appreciate it. I'm sure all the other business owners do as well.
Yeah, I hope so. I love doing it, as you can tell. So, keep going, everyone. We're all doing such a good job. And get around your local businesses, because they're the heart and soul of our community.
Come and see us for an ice cream car wash or a limo ride.
Absolutely. I will be. Don't worry. Thanks, everyone. Right. Bye.